In this figure, let's examine the intercalated cells and how they aid in pH regulation. And the intercalated cells are found in the late distal convoluted tubule over here, as well as in the early collecting duct over here. Now, the intercalated cells are found interspersed between the principal cells of these same nephron segments, the principal cells being more intimately involved in ion regulation. The intercalated cells do some of that, but they are definitely focused on pH regulation. And they fall into two main groups. There's a type A cell that is an acid secreting cell, and a type B cell that is a base secreting cell. So we're going to examine two scenarios where one or the other of these cell types becomes more active. And so in the first scenario, we're going to have a pH of less than 7.4, our normal pH of extracellular fluids. That would be an acidosis. And then, of course, the opposite would be an alkalosis when pH is above normal or above 7.4. Now, pH regulation in general has three main steps. The first step is buffering, which is the binding or releasing of free protons from anions. There is carbon dioxide regulation at the respiratory membranes. If carbon dioxide were to accumulate, as shown here in the carbonic acid equation, that carbon dioxide combines with water to produce, we drive this to the right, producing free protons and decreasing our pH. If we were to increase ventilation, our CO2 levels would fall, and we would drive the reaction the opposite direction. Free proton levels would fall and pH would rise. Now, finally, and most potently, renal regulation of pH occurs through the adjustment of free protons and bicarbonate ions themselves. And we see that through these intercalated cells. Now, let's examine our acidosis first. And one thing that's common to both of these cell types, however, is that they both run this carbonic acid equation. The difference is, what do they do with these end products, the free proton and the bicarbonate ion? So here's our carbonic acid equation again. But in the case of the acid-secreting cell, we're going to take the free proton and we're going to drive it into the nephron fluid, the tubular fluid, using a pump, an ATPase. Some of it will be excreted, but some of it will combine with filtered bicarbonate, and that filtered bicarbonate will recombine, there's carbonic anhydrase expressed in here as well on these membranes, will recombine and form carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide is lipophilic. It will enter these nephrons and supply the reaction we initially saw. You'll note the bicarbonate is being driven into the interstitium and being reabsorbed. So the net effect here is that we're secreting protons and we're reabsorbing or even making new bicarbonate that's saved, and it adds to our buffering capacity of the extracellular fluids. If we are alkaline, if our pH is greater than 7.4, the type B cells become more active. We run the exact same carbonic acid equation, but in this case, our free protons are going to be transported into the interstitium and saved. They're going to be added to the extracellular fluid, reducing the pH there. Right? Our pH was too high. Conversely, the bicarbonate ion, our buffering capacity, will fall as we counter-transport that bicarbonate into the nephron, enhancing its excretion, again, helping us maintain normal pH overall.